ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States and Mrs. Reagan.
Thank you. got a heart. He is a wimp. Hidey, 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 hide. Give him a home with the gold and steel, a diamond car with the platinum wheels. Each week she gave worlds and doves and corpses. $1 million worth of nickels and dimes. Sat around and count them all a million times. Hidey, 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 hidey. Hidey, 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 hidey. Hidey, 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 ho.
Paid in foreign markets, although I understand in Japan that Cattle Queen of Montana lost something in translation. Entertainment covers a broad range of artistic endeavors, big and small. Let it never be overlooked that our freedom also manifests itself in off-Broadway productions, the community theaters, church plays and choirs, the street entertainers, the circuses, and all those comedy acts and musical groups that can be found in towns and hamlets all across America. In many countries, entertainers are not so free. They often must have their performances approved by government officials. Not long ago, we had dinner with Yakov Smirnov, a comedian from the Soviet Union, now a proud United States citizen practicing his trade here in this new country. Yakov remembers how he was required to get official approval for all the material he would use in the year ahead. Annually, he would trace to a bureaucratic enclave in the Ministry of Culture called, this is a rough translation, the Department of Humor. That's no joke, the Department of Humor. Yakov says the only advantage the Soviet comedians have is they're always playing to a captive audience. In our country, people are free to speak and free to tell a joke even betwixt the nose of a government official. Even though that scar on my nose is from too much sun. Our good humor is one of our greatest national assets. Entertainment has been a lively part of the American scene from our earliest days. For all those American entertainers of yesterday, today and tomorrow, Ford's Theater represents their important contribution to our way of life. This theater continues a great American tradition and broadens appreciation for the theater arts. So Nancy and I extend to you our deepest appreciation for your help in maintaining this historic site. Thanks to all those who performed for us tonight. When I saw David Copperfield hanging there in midair over that sword, I know that he now understands what it feels like to be a candidate for public office. Seriously, though, this has been a wonderful evening for a worthy cause. A special word of appreciation to Joy Baker, Betty Wright, Billy O'Neill, Carol Laxalt for their commitment to Ford's Theater, and also Mary Jane Wick and Frankie Hewitt for all the hard work they put for making this a memorable show than it has been. So, thank you to all of you. God bless you all.